Hi, I'm Reto Meier for The Developer Show. This is your update about the coolest developer news from Google in the last week. The second annual TensorFlow Developer Summit was held on March 30th, and, as you could predict, it was awesome. But don't worry if you missed the event or the live stream. This post has all the highlights, including how we're making TensorFlow easier to use, work on more languages and platforms, and how we're expanding the community resources. The Dev Show crew was also on site to interview some speakers, so watch for those videos coming soon. D8 is the next generation DEX compiler that runs faster and produces smaller DEX files with equivalent or better runtime performance when compared to the historic compiler. And D8 is now the default DEX compiler. To learn more, including the deprecation plan for DX, take a look at the post. The Google Fonts catalog now includes Korean web fonts for those of you working with the Hangul writing system. To learn more about these fonts and the Google Fonts API, head for the post. Last year, we introduced MobileNetV1, a family of general-purpose computer vision neural networks designed with mobile devices in mind to support classification, detection, and more. MobileNetV2 is now available, and it's a significant improvement over MobileNetV1, pushing the state-of-the-art for mobile visual recognition, including classification, object detection, and semantic segmentation. Links to the TensorFlow Slim image classification library, collaboratory, Jupyter Notebook, and GitHub repo are all in the post. Cloud Functions for Firebase helps you build back-end functionality for your app without worrying about managing servers. Version 1.0 of the Cloud Functions for Firebase SDK is now available, with frequently requested improvements for the development, testing, and monitoring of functions. More details are in the post. GitLab and Google Cloud recently announced a new integration of GitLab and Kubernetes Engine. You can now connect your Kubernetes Engine cluster to your GitLab project and then use it to run your continuous integration jobs and configure a complete continuous deployment pipeline, including previewing your changes live and deploying them into production. Getting started instructions and screenshots are all in the post. Logging and monitoring are the cornerstones of network and security operations. They let you identify traffic and access patterns that may present security or operational risks to your organization. We recently introduced VPC Flow Logs, which increase transparency into your network and allow you to track network flows all the way down to an individual virtual interface in near real time. A flowchart and screen grab are in the post. Please remember to like, subscribe, and share. I'm Reto Meier for The Developer Show. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next week. These are always such tongue twisters.